Hello friends, welcome to this video on quadrilaterals. In the previous video, we discussed about quadrilateral and its types. We specifically studied about parallelograms. Today we will discuss some properties of a parallelogram. Let's construct a parallelogram PQRS. If we combine these two vertices in this way to form diagonal QS, then we will get these two triangles. Can we say something about these triangles? Friends, will these two triangles be congruent? Let's check it out. This is a parallelogram. Therefore, side PQ is parallel to side SR and QS is the diagonal. So, both these angles PQS and angle RSQ will be equal as these are alternate interior angles. Similarly, angle PSQ and angle RQS will also be equal. Now look at triangles PSQ and RQS. Here, this pair of two angles are equal and side SQ is the common side. Therefore, both these triangles are congruent according to the ASA congruence rule. Now we can say that diagonal QS divides parallelogram PQRS into two congruent triangles. Friends, you can make diagonal PR in the same way and check the congruence of the triangles. You will come to the conclusion that diagonal PR also divides quadrilateral PQRS into two congruent triangles. Friends, this is the property of a parallelogram and we can write it as a theorem. A diagonal of a parallelogram divides it into two congruent triangles. And as we know that corresponding parts of congruent triangles are equal, therefore, the corresponding sides of these triangles will also be equal. That is, side PQ is equal to side RS and side PS is equal to side RQ. Friends, note that these sides are opposite sides of this parallelogram. This is another property of a parallelogram, and we can write this also as a theorem, that the opposite sides of a parallelogram are equal. Friends, will the converse of this theorem also be true? That is, if each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then will that quadrilateral be a parallelogram? Suppose the opposite sides of quadrilateral ABCD are equal, then we have to prove that it is a parallelogram. That is, if we draw a diagonal AC here, then the alternate angles formed by the intersection of sides AB and DC are equal. So these lines will be parallel. With the help of these two triangles, triangle ABC and triangle CDA, we can prove them to be parallel. We can see that in both these triangles, side AB is equal to side CD, side BC is equal to side DA, and side AC is the common side. Hence, both these triangles are congruent according to the SSS congruence rule. That is, angle BAC and angle DCA will be equal and they form a pair of alternate angles. We know that if a transversal intersects two lines in such a way that a pair of alternate interior angles are equal, then the two lines are parallel. This means side AB will be parallel to side DC. Repeating the same process, by drawing diagonal BD, we can prove side AD also parallel to side BC. Now its opposite sides are parallel. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. We can write this result in the form of a theorem as follows. If each pair of opposite sides of a quadrilateral is equal, then it is a parallelogram. Friends, we obtain this result for the opposite sides of a parallelogram. Can we say something about its opposite angles? Like the opposite sides of a parallelogram, will the pair of opposite angles also be equal? Let's check. Draw a parallelogram DEFG. Now with the help of a protractor, find the measure of its opposite angles. You can see that the measure of angle D and angle F is equal and the measure of angle E and angle G is also equal. friends, by pausing this video, you can repeat this activity for other parallelograms. With this, you will come to the conclusion that the opposite angles of all parallelograms are equal. This is another property of a parallelogram. But will its converse also be true? Let's see. If we are given that in a quadrilateral ABCD, each pair of its opposite angles are equal, then will it be a parallelogram? Let's examine it. Friends, we have studied the angle sum property of a quadrilateral. Using it, we can write these angles as follows. As we are given that the measure of angle A is equal to angle C and the measure of angle B is equal to angle D. Therefore, in equation 1, we can substitute angle A in place of angle C and angle B in place of angle D. Now, we can simplify equation 1 in this way. We will get angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degrees. Look at the figure carefully. If side AB is considered to be the transversal of side AD and side BC, then angle A and angle B are the interior angles on the same side of the transversal. And the sum of these two angles is 180 degrees. These are supplementary angles. Friends, we know that if a transversal intersects two lines in such a way that one pair of interior angles on the same side of the transversal is supplementary, then the two lines are parallel to each other. Now using the theorem, we can say that AD and BC are parallel sides. Friends, repeating this activity by pausing the video, you can prove sides AB and DC to be parallel to each other. In this way, that is, we can say that the converse of the theorem is also true. Therefore, we can write it in the form of a theorem as follows. If each pair of opposite angles of a quadrilateral is equal, then that quadrilateral is a parallelogram. Friends, that's all in this session. Today we discussed some properties of a parallelogram and proved some theorem based on them. See you in the next video with some properties of a parallelogram. Thank you.